time to stop the show. Bless my heart and bless my soul.
It was just something we've never seen before on this show.
I just happen to have a group of students, plumbers, engineers, and it just works. Gone from a plumber to now we're selling out the O2. We're not plumbers anymore, we're not engineers anymore, we're not students anymore. We are diversity.
Welcome to Diversity Live. Activating systems.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Diversity Live! We are so excited to have our own show. And remember, we are live, so anything can happen. So we're going to need to be kept in check. So make some noise for our wonderful host, Alicia Dixon.
Thank you guys for having me on stage. excited to be with you tonight. It's going to be amazing. Now, in the next hour, you are going to see these boys like you have never seen them before, including a tap routine, some very personal stories, and a finale you'll have to see to believe. Now, just in case you've been living under a rock for the past 5 years, let's go back to where it all began.
Ash is the single most talented man I have ever met.
Jordan.
Oh, I was gonna
One word.
Jordan.
Crazy.
He's off his head 24/7.
What, how old is Mitchell?
18? 18.
He's 18 going on 80.
Ike has this funny thing that he does. He turns American.
What's crack-a-lacking? That's what's up. From out of nowhere.
Pell's one that every girl just wants to touch his hair. He'll do anything for anyone.
Sam, he's like Mr. T, not big black Mohican Mr. T. Cup of tea.
Warren's that dude, that massive smart one.
You know what he's thinking because he'll just tell you.
Tell's a man's man.
Terry is just English.
My dad was a boxer, my mum was a ballerina, and my dad turned his boxing gym into a dance studio.
I decided to set up a studio because if you weren't a certain build or shape or had a particular background, a lot of raw talent was being completely missed.
One by one, these kind of like little ragamuffin boys started to come into the studio. And they were just in the corner like this. And then when they started to see that there were more boys and that it was actually quite cool, they joined themselves, and then slowly but surely we all became friends.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Dancer.
You want to be a dancer? Ashley?
Fireman.
Want to be a fireman? Any particular reason for that? No?
Just want to.
You just want to? You don't want to dance?
Right. I watched London's Burning.
Can you not? I'm in my trunks, mate.
Terry is the butchest guy you've ever seen. And he kind of just came with his sister. Me and Terry became friends like 18 years ago.
I was watching Justin Timberlake, one of his music videos, and he was dancing. And then literally from that moment, I was like, that's what I want to do.
I met Ike when I was buying a phone.
This girl that works with me, she kind of introduced me to them and said, oh yeah, this is Ike. Ike can dance, by the way.
I was like, oh really? Just come down. And he kind of, in the middle of a shopping center somewhere, just did this for me. And I was like, I'll come to the studio. Bang, Ike was in the group.
The only reason Sam's actually even in the group is because my mum found a dance studio and I was literally too scared to go, so if it weren't for me,
then I was here.
He wouldn't be here either.
Perry was a super fan.
There was a fashion show which was run by Ashley's mum, and next minute, this group of dancers come on stage, Diversity. Something just clicked.
Little did I know, little did he know, all of that talent that was stored up inside him, and I saw it and I was just like, this kid's special.
When I first began dancing, I jumped with my two other brothers and we ended up just joining Danny's dance school.
He came to the studio, was a little bit arrogant, knocked him down a peg, and he's in the group.
Britain's Got Talent, it is the craziest thing that's ever happened to all of us.
And who are you?
We're Diversity.
What are the chances of you guys winning this? Good?
Good, good. We'd like to think so. We'd like to think so.
The whole experience was just crazy. One of the first times I danced with Diversity was on that Britain's Got Talent stage.
I've never seen dance so imaginative, so creative, so entertaining. It was just something we'd never seen before on this show. It was taking dance to a whole different area.
Got through to the final. As far as I was concerned, that was good enough.
Everyone was a lot more relaxed and just like proud to be here. There weren't really anything more to like prove.
Well, it was the Susan Ball year, so all anyone was talking about at that time, to be fair, was Susan.
She is insanely talented. She was an internet sensation.
Susan's gonna win. Who's gonna come second?
The winner of Britain's Got Talent 2009 is...
We're going home. Like, we're 110% going home.
Diversity!
I think everybody's like that. Because no one could believe it.
Everyone drops, everyone starts crying. It was just really real.
If a dance group who had probably some of the lowest odds in the final, beating the most popular contestant ever, that's not meant to be, then I don't know what is.
Yeah!
You guys have been on such an amazing journey, and everyone can see it. Look, we've given you a chance to get your breath back. So, I want to ask you a few questions. Now, Perry, you must get this all the time. You have seriously grown.
You know what? I'm just...
Right?
Just making them gains. gymming it, protein shakes.
I love it. And, Ash, I'm sorry to do this to you, but we've got to take a look at that picture again.
Oh, God.
That is so sweet. How old were you there?
I was about eight.
And what happened to your dream of becoming a fireman?
Gone up in smoke.
Gone up in smoke. Very nice, Perry. Well done. Now, Jordan, you're Ashley's brother, so come on, is there anything else we should know about him?
Okay. Ash looks pretty cool, right? He's a nice little hat, his little goatee, he's a nice little smooth jacket. Okay, here's something he didn't know. He owns a farm hat and he has a vegetable patch.
I'm
not joking. He keeps a vegetable patch. He grows his own vegetables. I don't know what he does. I don't know why he does it.
Farmer Ashley.
Yeah, I like freshly grown vegetables. I don't know if you're in the
room. I love it. Okay, on that note, Ashley, what else is coming up later?
Well, later on, I'm so excited because we are going to step back in time and we are going to pay tribute to the greats from Astaire, Sinatra, Jackson, all the people that have inspired us.
Fantastic. I cannot wait for that. Join us after the break for that step back in time. See you then. Woo! Welcome back to Diversity Live. Now, winning Britain's Got Talent in that record-breaking year meant the lives of the group would never be the same. But for one particular member of Diversity, simply being accepted into the group was something that would change his life forever.
I was quite a quiet kid. I mean, I never spoke to anyone. If you ask any of the other boys, like, they must have thought I was so rude because I just didn't speak to anyone. Like, people would say hello and I'd just be like, just give them a little nod. I think the only word I said to Ash was backflip.
When I first met Perry, he didn't talk. I mean, he was literally like shattered confidence, small kid.
School was just a bit strange for me. I just turned up, done some lessons and left.
Perry definitely had a hard time at school just because he was shy. He's got big hair, glasses, you know, he likes dancing. You're always going to get kids that want to pick on other kids like that. And he found the studio, you know, he found Diversity, he found that whole world.
It was a place where they could walk through the door and walk out of the door feeling that they had friends, they could talk to people and actually feel better about themselves.
I think throughout my life I was just trying to find something where I could just open up a bit. Once I found dancing, I think that made me me.
In that one session, I taught him about five moves. Like, I remember teaching him backflip off the wall, teaching him like how to start a windmill, and I was thinking to myself, this kid just gets it. He physically gets it. But why doesn't he talk?
Danny sat me down. She was like, so we want you to be a member of the group. And I don't think I've ever been so excited in my life. I'm actually getting a bit emotional. I'm just really grateful.
Through dance, he became different, he became rehabilitated. And if you look at him now, you know, he's not cocky, he's not arrogant. I just feel that he's confident.
To see Perry turn into just a beautiful person, if I've played a part in that, then maybe I've done my job.
Without dancing, I wouldn't be who I am today. So I'm just very grateful for dancing, for letting me be who I am.
He's content and he's happy. And that's because of dancing, nothing else. Because of meeting us and dancing.
Thank you.
goodness, that was so amazing. So emotional. Shortly we'll have a very special routine that pays tribute to some of the many artists to have influenced diversity, from Fred Astaire to Michael Jackson. But first, let's find out about the icons who have inspired their career.
Fred Astaire, Gene Kelly, Frank Sinatra, they embody the word smooth. There are certain people that just don't have to try. Someone like Fred Astaire can stand in front of a camera and just go, and it's like, oh.
I'd say for me personally, like Justin Timberlake. It's the first music video I think he dropped in a solo career. The dancing in it was just like, I was like, wow. Like, he's such a smooth fella. I was like, yeah, I'd love to be able to move like that.
One of my biggest influences is definitely Michael Jackson.
The single greatest performer, visionary artist ever.
There's this move called a tutting, stuff like that, you know. MJ was doing it from like 1986. The way he was hitting it back then, mm-hmm. Oh my days. We watched it like a few days ago, and we were going, woo!
He's that good that he invented his own style of movement, which is incredibly difficult to do. If you put a bag over his head, instantly you'd know that's Michael Jackson. A big influence of mine are the Nicholas brothers. They are an incredible pair of dancers. These guys, all those years ago, in tap shoes and tucks and tails, were doing things that would be physically impressive now. They were around in a time when, I suppose, racism was a little more relevant. They didn't get as far as they should have. Every single time I watch them, I'm absolutely blown away by their performance level, by their physicality. They are just the example of when a person or two people are given a talent to do something, and they are just, they are it, they are dance.
I've got something to tell you. You know we're doing a routine based around our influences, the Nicholas brothers, right?
Yep. Yeah.
To help give us some inspiration, some tips, I've called in the big guns.
Yeah.
Your granddaughters, the Nicholas sisters.
They were in over 80 motion pictures throughout their career, and every time you see them, they always look incredible. They're always well dressed, and they always have these incredible dance numbers.
So, shuffle, front, back. It's that easy, yeah?
They came up during a tough time in American history where there was a lot of racism, and it was very tough to be a black person in America and certainly a black entertainer. Sometimes they had to come in through the kitchen in a venue in which they were performing. They were not allowed to walk in through the front door. Still, they would come out with a smile. They would come out and give you an incredible show. And they knew that even though they had to deal with a lot of that, that they had to be a part of turning that around.
Where are your arms? What happened? There we go. And you have to smile. What's on the ground? Nothing. There we go.
I was getting naked.
And these films were shot in the 1940s, the 1950s, decades ago, where there was no CGI, there were no special effects, and still they were able to do these incredible things that even today are still really remarkable.
You're gonna be awesome. We're looking forward to seeing you. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank you. Diversity!
People say you're riding high in April, shot down in May. I've been a puppet, a pauper, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I just hit myself and get back.
I think you are fabulous.
You've come all
the way from America to be here tonight. How was that for you?
That was incredible. We have been following the guys ever since they won Britain's Got Talent a number of years ago, and we are so inspired by what they do.
And they are genuinely great guys. I always tell them I'm the president of their fan club.
I know. And look, you know, your grandfather, what would he have made of this?
He would have been very proud. As you heard, during their heyday, it was an incredibly racist time in the States, and oftentimes they couldn't get work, so they had to come over to Europe to perform. Yes. And the UK was a country that embraced them. Also, they were about spreading
happiness and positivity through dance. They'd be happy to see diversity carrying on that legacy.
I know. And Ashley, you've been a fan of the Nicholas Brothers your whole life. How was that for you?
I am honoured, privileged,
out of breath,
and humbled, and out of breath, but genuinely to have you guys dancing with us. I am a massive fan of the Nicholas Brothers,
yeah,
and I'm now a massive fan of the Nicholas Sisters.
So are we. Thank you so much, guys. Now, we'll be back after the break with more spectacular live performances, and Ashley will be making a very special and emotional trip to the home of the English National Ballet. See you in a bit.
Diversity are back with the Up Close and Personal Tour, live in 2015. Diversity, Up Close and Personal. Tickets on sale now at gigsandtours.com and ticketmaster.co.uk.
Welcome back to Diversity Live. Now, Ashley, how's tonight going for you so far?
Tonight has been incredible. I mean, we're live, so
yeah,
it's really scary, but this audience is amazing.
We're so nervous for you. Now, I want to talk to you about ballet. So, your mum was a ballet dancer, and I believe that ballet was the first dance that you studied. Is that right?
Indeed. My mum was a ballet dancer, and she was my first teacher, and I was at
Amazing.
The bar with my little ballet shoes. That
nice.
Was the first style of dance I
Love
did.
Love that. Yeah. And what was it about ballet that you loved so much?
With ballet, it is the grace and the elegance, but underneath it all, the power. I mean, pound for pound, ballet dancers are some of the strongest people on the planet, and I think they're amazing.
What do you prefer, street or ballet?
To do. Street, because I'm really bad at ballet.
And I heard you recently visited the English National Ballet, so how was that?
I did indeed, and it was one of the most inspirational trips ever, because I've always believed that dance is more than choreography, more than moves. It's bigger, it can be used to heal, you know, mentally, physically. And I met some extremely inspirational people and saw what dance is doing for them.
Sounds absolutely incredible. Okay, let's take a look at how Ashley got on when he visited Dance for Parkinson's.
Tell me about Parkinson's itself. How has that affected you? How does it limit you? How has it affected your movement?
Well, I started off with a tremor, which is a nuisance. It's gradually got worse, and so it limits you in what you can do.
The key characteristics of Parkinson's are tremor, slowness of movement, and rigidity of muscles.
Dance for Parkinson's is a national hub programme for English National Ballet. We run weekly classes here in London that have been going since 2010, where we invite participants with Parkinson's, their carers, friends and family members to attend a ballet class here in the studio.
It's not a therapy class, it's not an exercise class, it is a ballet class. And they learn the same rep as the company are performing at any given time.
This class is giving them an opportunity to connect with their bodies physically in a way that gives them grace, gives them stability, gives them an opportunity to perform, express, and to go away from the studio thinking, maybe I'm not just defined by my Parkinson's.
We've seen an improvement in balance, which may therefore lead to a decreased fall risk as well. Improved posture.
How are they helping you? In what way?
Well, partly freedom of movement, and partly from the sort of psychological point of view. I always feel elated when I leave a class, and I want to go and talk to everybody on the bus on the way home.
The group activity is remarkable. It gives you enthusiasm and a sort of more of a will to live.
I just love the fact that as hard as it is, you found something that you love to do. And the fact that you found it through dance is so inspiring for me. And I think you are absolutely amazing. I really, really do.
Thank you.
No problems. Come here.
Parkinson's is really affecting so many people in this room in such a severe way, but as soon as the music starts and they're dancing and they take on those characters, it instantly, in the moment, somehow heals them. And
it's amazing to see in front of my eyes. There's people that are shaking, people that have tremors, people that can't really tell the left from the right, and the music comes on and they just dance, and it is just incredible. And the power of dance is amazing, and here right now I've been inspired, I've been humbled, and I'm so happy that I was invited down and I've had the opportunity to be a part of this class.
Some impressive routines tonight. Tell me about the training that's gone into tonight.
Do you know what? I think I can speak for all of us when I say our heart and soul has gone into this tonight. I mean, it's been the biggest moment of our lives, and we're so grateful to have this opportunity, so thank you so much.
It's been amazing, and you've been working so hard. I know, I heard you were training on Christmas Day, is that true, Ashley?
That is true. We were doing like 8 a.m. till like 8 p.m. Christmas Day, yeah.
That's a little mean though, right?
Sorry, boys.
You didn't even get a Christmas dinner?
Well, no, we did.
Okay.
We did, good.
Now, I hear some of you were injured as well, is that true?
Yeah, I got injured.
Are you okay now?
Yeah, now I am. I tried to tank a little out of my depth, hurt myself. Yeah. That's right now.
You're showing off, mate. Now, Ashley, since winning Britain's Got Talent, you guys are going from strength to strength. You know, you're travelling the world, sell out tours. What's next for you guys?
Well, it has been such a privilege to be able to do what we do the way we love to do it. And we've just announced our sick UK tour.
All right, round of applause. That's amazing. Yeah.
And we've launched a hat and clothing brand, and we're in talk to take what we do, our shows, worldwide. So basically,
diversity is taking over the world.
Kind of, presidential. Yeah.
Presidential, yeah. Absolutely love that, guys. You've done so amazing. Now, Warren, we've seen lots of special guests tonight, you know, and you keep adding to the diversity family. You know, how important is it for you to keep bringing people in, and what do I have to do to get a place in the group?
Well, you look good as it is, so.
They think they're charming, don't they? Yeah, so that's all I've got to do, stand there, yeah? Lovely. Oh, guys, you are fantastic. Now, 5 years in diversity, any moments that stand out for you guys? Mitchell?
For me, personally, it'd be Royal Variety. Give me that, mate. Yeah. For me, yeah, performing for the Queen twice, yeah, that is my highlight.
Give it back, Mitchell.
Really, we'll give the boys a chance to get their breath back, but we'll be right back with a show-stopping finale. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to Diversity Live. Now, in a moment, we'll see the guys perform in tonight's finale, but for now, in case you're wondering what the future holds for diversity, we took our cameras down to their dance school to see how the next generation of dancers are shaping up.
For me, true success is legacy. That is what I want diversity to leave. Teaching the next generation, teaching the kids, passing on what we know and bringing them into our performances, and we do that here in our dance studio.
This is a place where any kid, no matter what age, no matter what colour, what race, they can come here and escape life, what they've been in. They can come and just be free. You can feel accepted no matter who you are.
Dream, believe, achieve is our motto, and I think that's really evident in people like Perry, who came from a kid who didn't talk into being one of the brightest, funniest, most talented kids I know. And it's also really evident in people like Warren and Sam.
Go to the side, play the guitar.
I grew up in, I think, an age where knife crime and robberies and just the whole gang culture exploded, like, vastly as well across London. When I was younger, I thought it was cool to hang out on the streets and that, and I was doing graffiti, I was getting arrested and things like this, and the people I was hanging around with just really wasn't a positive vibe for my life in general.
I went to a school where it was in like a rough area, so I knew quite a lot of people who were doing bad things.
Up and down, hit.
When I come to the studio, I went, I'm changing my life, like this is it. For me, the friends I had, they can go, they're not going to benefit me.
It was either going to be the studio and dancing, or it was the wrong crowd of people and going down this wrong path. And I honestly believe that if it wasn't for the studio and it wasn't for Danny and Ashley and that, and I genuinely don't know whether I would still actually be alive.
We've had something special here. Jordan, when he first started at 4.5, was lacking in confidence. He's just a totally different child now.
Dance is for anyone, like, no matter what. So, like, if you're race, age, or etc. like that, you can still do dance, because dance is freedom.
Dancing with diversity has changed my life. It is amazing.
Whoever walks through the door is
family. It's just lovely, and it's really inspirational knowing that the guys are literally just next door. They come out, they'll socialise with everyone. It's literally, it's a wicked dance school, but it's just like having that family orientated feel. It's just, it is really good.
We're going to open up some academies all around the country, just get kids involved, get them in dancing, get them off the streets, get them focused.
If us, as a group of randoms, can get to where we've got to, I genuinely do believe that anything's possible. If when we're no longer doing what we're doing, people can say, I'm here today doing what I'm doing because I saw diversity do it. That's really the legacy I want to leave.
And you can look out for a few of the performers you've just seen in the next routine. Now, Perry, I've got to ask you this. What is the best thing about being in diversity?
As cheesy as it sounds, I get to spend every single day with my best friends, and you know, none of that would be possible without all of you guys.
That's not cheesy. Love that, that's so sweet. Look, guys, you better go and get ready, okay? Good luck. We're nearly ready for our grand finale, guys, so we'd like to say a big thank you to all the fantastic performers who have joined Diversity tonight, including the magnificent Nicholas sisters, the wonderful Boadicea ladies, the supremely talented Theo, Urban Voices Collective, and all the fantastic musicians. Now look into the future with the help of the next generation of dancers for a finale that will blow your socks off. For the last time tonight, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise and go crazy for Diversity!
Your time, your moment, and nothing can stop us now. Yeah, PTX, get up, what it is, what it does, what it is, what it is. Looking for a better way to get a better, better getting on the internet and checking out of here again. I wish I could jump up and then I'll come a little bit of caution. Somewhere between that black eating copies, but I gave up.
Incredible experiences of our lives, and we feel so privileged to be on this stage, and we want to thank everybody who has supported us from the start. We had a dream, we believed, and we achieved, and this is only the beginning. We are diverse.
Yeah.
wake up for the first proper week of 2015 with our Good Morning Britain team tomorrow from 6. And catch up on last night's Love Lift antics from the new series of Take Me Out on ITV Player anytime ahead of next Saturday's show at 8.05. Coming up tonight, the aftermath of war, spies, bribes and corruption. It's a brand new series of Foyle's War next.